Hey friends, welcome back. I'm Trailblazer Tim. So today is going to be the first in a series of videos that I'm going to be putting out over the course of the summer on a restoration project that I've decided to get myself into. But before we start that, as promised, I'm going to give everybody out there a small little update on the old Bamboo Paradise base camp. So earlier this year, everybody out there saw me start on a base camp build across the tracks. Really cool project made out of bamboo and stuff, had a little emergency tarp shelter and a pit grill. About a month and a half ago, I went back there and discovered it had been vandalized. Now, we knew we were getting involved in a risky kind of little situation. The emergency tarp shelter, the pit grill, everything was gone and the camp was knocked over. Now, I don't know who did it and I don't care. I'm not mad, I'm disappointed. We'll move on from that. Not to mention the fact that the Florida East Coast Railway is working feverishly through this county and spending millions of dollars on getting everything up to date because we have a high-speed train that's going to be coming in here by the end of the year. So it's very dangerous going back by those tracks and it's being patrolled very tightly. I apologize to you guys. The three people that I promised the bamboo mugs and stuff to make, that's not going to happen because I'm not going back to that area, but I promise I will compensate you guys sooner or later. Thanks, and let's get on to that new project that I was talking about. As everybody knows, I'm an outdoorsman. I love the outside, water, fishing, and stuff like that. But I've been away from the aspect of fishing for quite some time, and I want to get back into doing that. So I decided to break down. I found a great deal, and we got ourselves an old fishing boat. We're going to make a restoration on it. Check it out. A 15.5-foot aluminum deep V-haul fishing boat. This sucker is solid. We're going to do a full walk around. I'm going to show you the goods and the bads, the uglies and the beauties. So let's get started. Just picked this up yesterday. I had to drive south about 60 miles from here, and everything that you see here came with it for one price. We'll talk about that in a minute. The boat, the trailer, an outboard motor, a fish finder, all that good stuff. But it has some things that I need to get done on here before I want to put it out in the water. So let's start with the trailer. Now, if you look closely, this is an oversized boat trailer. It's larger than what's needed for this 15.5-foot aluminum V-haul boat. This is a 1990, and I'm not sure what brand it is. There's a little aluminum kind of plate that's up towards the hull, but it has paint over it. I think that's the only way I'm going to identify it. This is a very, very solid boat trailer, and I'm going to show you a couple little foibles that's going on here that I have to get taken care of. First things first, our little wheel wells here around the tires and stuff, they're starting to fall apart. They're rotting out. So that's on the right-hand side of the trailer. Let's go to the other side and I'll show you what kind of damage that has. Now, if you look closely on the other side of this boat trailer, you can see, yeah, that whole plate is junk. All right, it's not part of the frame, it's just the skirting and stuff. So I'm gonna have to take, and I'm gonna cut that all out. I've got a fabricator that's up by where I work, and he'll take and put regular fender flares on here for me. It won't cost me an arm and a leg. Tires on both sides are in very good condition. The boat has sat for a little while, but now you can actually kind of see where I was just pointing at. That's all rotted out, but it only goes up to a certain area. So that spot right there is gonna end up coming out of there. The frame itself is 100% solid. Onto the trailer winch, as you can see, it's pretty much new. However, the rope cable on there is pretty much garbage. I'm gonna get that off of there during the restoration, replace it with a 2-inch wide, rated for 1,500-pound nylon strap. So that's not a problem. Last but not least on this trailer, we're gonna end up rewiring it. You can see that harness mess and everything. That does not match up with a Hummer. So we're gonna just run all new wiring down the length of this thing and make sure all the lights and everything work as well. That's not a big issue. That'll be an afternoon project as well. All part of the restoration. All in all, this trailer is structurally very sound except for a few little foibles which aren't really that difficult to fix. It's solid, good tires, all that stuff. Let's move on to the boat and I'll show you what we got going on there. All right, if we take an overlook of this 15.5-foot V-haul aluminum boat, the boat itself is structurally sound. There is no repairs, no patches, no big dents, nothing. It is a solid heavy-duty boat. However, there are some things, and we'll take closer looks, like that old plastic seat that swivels. It's junk, it's cracked. All that shag carpet that's happening up in there, that stuff's all going away. Let's take a look at some of the features that this boat came with. So like I mentioned, I just picked this boat up yesterday, and everything that I'm showing you is exactly what came with the boat. I haven't done nothing but park the thing. So let's take a look at the stern end of the boat first. All right, so the previous owner decided to try a restoration on here, but of course he didn't go all the way through. Back here on the back, as you can see right here on both sides, I mounted new little foldable lights, which are very nice. They're not wired in. They're just pretty much mounted at this point when I got one on this side and one on the other side. But that's just one less thing I have to buy. Pretty sweet. Now onto the good stuff. This came with the boat. This is a brand new Coleman 2.6 four-stroke motor. Now, 2.6, I'm not sure if that's a horsepower or whatever. I watched a couple videos. This thing's got a lot of power. If you look up on the top area, this doesn't have a holding gas tank. It is actually right in here. And the guy told me, he says, you can fill that thing up and run for 3-4 hours. No problem without any gas. So I didn't hear this run, but I will take this motor off and put it in my barrel and check it out and all that stuff. It's got to come off here anyways for us to do the restore on the boat. I also threw in a handful of oars for the boat. You know, it's not like I'm going to use them, but it's always good to have them in case your motor fails and you got to get to shore. Also came equipped with a brand new Hummingbird Piranha Max 4 fish finder. That thing is brand new, still had the plastic on it and everything, and it's ran the wire all the way to the back where the sensor is. We'll have to make some modifications of where that thing is going to end up, but right there out of the gates, that's a few hundred dollars. That's something else that I don't have to get. Not to mention, if you look down closely in that area, there's two nice new marker lights that are in the front as well. Something else I don't have to buy. All right, onto the seats and stuff. This plastic thing is busted and it's junk. This thing's coming out, got big old crack right in there and stuff. I don't want that in here. Moving on to the benches, got the old shag carpet. That crap's coming out of here. And I'll tell you what my intentions for the rest of the interior are gonna be. Back here in the stern, came equipped with a drain hole, as you can see there, and it came with a couple plugs. So just one less thing that I have to buy on this boat, which gives me more of an opportunity to put my money where it really counts. Hold on, that's a whole lot for a boat package to get all in one. There's more. Check this out. This boat also came equipped with a Motor Guide R3 trolling motor. Fully equipped and ready to be installed. Not to mention, this boat package came with a clean title. That's not a very easy thing when it comes to a boat that's 31 years old. All right, so my intentions for the restoration on the inside of this boat is we're gonna get rid of this old shag carpeting and stuff, this junky old seat and crap. The boat needs to be rewired. That's not a big deal, okay? I can do that because none of the lights or anything are all wired in. We're going to get a battery. We're going to put a compartment in here, probably a live well as well. And we're going to build the deck on here and possibly, if I can find the resources, some sort of a center console. This baby is going to be the ultimate little fishing boat by the end of the summer. I just temporarily parked my boat back there in this cut where my RV and stuff is. It's not allowed to stay here. It's just going to be here probably to the end of the day. I got a couple decisions to make. I can put it back here in storage where they have an area where I can park it, where I can work on it. Or I can opt out of that and take it up to where I work. It's got a big yard up there and set it up there. Of course, what I'm going to do is take that motor off here and we're going to take and put it away somewhere safe because I don't want to get that stolen. But all in all, that ain't a bad deal. How much did it all cost though, Tim? I found that boat on Marketplace on Facebook, and I looked around and around and around, and I saw all these different John boats and stuff. Most of them, they wanted $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, and it was without the trailer and stuff like that. That whole setup right there, I had to drive 60 miles south to Fort Pierce, Florida, and drove it back. $1,000. Now I looked this whole boat over, and the only place I can even think of how to identify the brand on this boat is this little aluminum plate that's sitting right here. Someone's painted over. The way I could get that paint off without ruining the identification on there, we may be able to ID what brand boat this is. It's top guess off my head is an old Lund, maybe a Starcraft or something. If anybody here that's watching this video might have an idea what type of boat this is, what brand it is. It was built in 1990, it's 15 and a half foot long, it's aluminum, and it's a deep V hull, and that's all I know about it, but it's a heck of a boat for the price. Well, that's all the time we've got for this one. Thanks so much for hanging out and watching the video. Any of you guys or gals out there or boat people, they may have some sort of an idea of what brand boat this is. I'd love to hear about it. Like I said, if I can clean that little plate off and get it so I might be able to identify, does it really matter? No, but it'd be nice that way. At least I'd know what I was working with. All in all, that boat right there and the trailer, the framework and stuff and the tires, everything is solid as you can possibly get. I've got some foibles and some things to work on with that, but that's what a project's all about. If I wanted to, I could put that thing on the water right now and get across over the islands, but we want this thing 100%. And I have part two of this series coming up next week where we're gonna dive in, we're gonna start taking out a bunch of the crap that's inside of that boat and start getting it towards getting ready to hit the water. Till next time, I'll see you on the next adventure. Take care.